Royal fans believe Meghan Markle brings bad luck and is a distraction for her friend Serena Williams after she watched from the sidelines for the third time as the tennis ace lost another big match. The Duchess of Sussex looked on as Ms. Williams was defeated by her Canadian opponent Bianca Andreescu by 6-3, 7-5, after traveling to New York on a commercial flight for her first overseas trip without baby Archie. Meghan's last-minute flight from Heathrow came just weeks after she and Prince Harry faced a backlash over their use of private jets. But royal watchers say instead of jetting across the pond on a first-class ticket which is believed to have cost more than £6,000, she should have stayed home because Ms. Williams was beaten in the US Open final. One Twitter user said, "She always loses when Meghan shows up. I like her but she's bad luck for Serena. She should stay away." Another said, "Meghan Markle, I love you girl but you need to leave. I feel like you are bad luck for Serena." A third person said the mother of one's presence at Flushing Meadows was too much distraction for Serena, who failed to win her 24th Grand Slam final. But others were quick to jump to Meghan's defense, arguing that having a supporting friend on hand would not normally make an athlete perform worse. One person said, "Presence of a person does not determine the results, the hard work of the player does. Meghan went there to support her friend, Serena did not lose because of her." Meghan, 38, was seen greeting Ms. Williams' mother Aura Sean Price at the US Open before taking her seat alongside Alexis Ohanian, the tennis star's husband. The loss came after Ms. Williams' coach Patrick Mouratoglou was reportedly worried about Meghan attending the game at Arthur Ashe Stadium. A source in the Williams camp told Page Six, "Serena asked her coach about Meghan coming when she won last night and everyone is worried, as tennis players are very superstitious, and Serena lost when Meghan came to watch her at Wimbledon." Meghan's trip to the US comes after she watched her pal lose the ladies' singles final at Wimbledon this summer, and she was also present at SW19 for Ms. Williams' defeat last year. She is believed to have boarded a plane at Heathrow on Friday, accompanied by a security team, after staying up late on Thursday to watch Ms. Williams beat Elena Svitolina in the semi-finals. On September 23, Meghan, Harry, and Archie will take part in their first overseas royal tour as a family of three when they travel to Southern Africa. While the Duchess and her four-month-old son will be based in Cape Town, South Africa, the Duke of Sussex will travel to Botswana, Angola, and Malawi solo. In a statement on their Instagram page, the Sussexes said they hope to focus on community, grassroots leadership, women's and girls' rights, mental health, HIV/AIDS and the environment. Meghan Markle watched her close pal Serena Williams suffer defeat in the US Open women's singles final in New York last night. But why are tennis fans calling for Meghan to be banned from her games? Meghan Markle, Duchess of Sussex, has been on maternity leave since April, but she has been spotted making selective appearances during that time. Whilst her close friend Serena Williams was competing at this year's Wimbledon competition, she was spotted twice attending her matches and cheering on her pal. The women first met at a Super Bowl party in 2010 and have been close friends ever since. But what is the heartbreaking reason why royal fans have taken to social media to appeal that the royal stops coming to watch Serena Williams play? Meghan has been accused of jinxing the world number one after the sportswoman's coaches reported raised concerns. It comes just a few months after Meghan watched Serena's defeat by Simona Halep during the Wimbledon final. Williams was also beaten at SW19 by Angelique Kerber in the Wimbledon final last year, which Meghan also attended. The tennis star was beaten again last night after she lost out on the top prize to Bianca Andreescu. This latest defeat means Serena once again failed to secure record-equaling 24th Grand Slam. After Serena's defeat on Saturday night, one Twitter user wrote, "Dear Meghan Markle, please stop attending Serena's finals matches. You are a jinx. Signed, fans who are not her friends." Another said, "Meghan. Duchess. Love you so much. Really do. Are you a jinx though? Has she been at most of the losses?" However, despite many blaming Meghan for Serena's losses, she has watched her friend win on occasion, including in 2016, When William successfully defended her title against Kerber, it is believed that it was during Meghan's trip to London on that occasion that she met Prince Harry for the first time. While Serena is likely thrilled to have her friend in the audience, her coach has reported expressed worry about Meghan's presence. According to the New York Post celebrity gossip site, Page Six, members of Serena's team were concerned and superstitious over the Duchess' presence. A source said, Serena asked her coach about Meghan coming when she won last night and everyone is worried, as tennis players are very superstitious, and Serena lost when Meghan came to watch her at Wimbledon. William's coach Patrick keeps telling her, focus, focus, focus. The aim is getting her to win her 24th Grand Slam. Meghan traveled to the US yesterday morning and is reportedly due to spend the weekend in New York City, before she returns to son Archie and husband Prince Harry. Meghan will be returning to work next Thursday when she attends a launch event for the charity clothing line she designed with her friend Miss Hanunuk. The royal revealed her partnership with her designer friend in the September issue of British Vogue, which she guest edited. The pair have created a capsule collection of women's workwear, all of which will benefit her patronage Smart Works, which is a charity that helps young women land jobs. In Vogue, Meghan wrote, when you walk into a Smart Works space, you're met with racks of clothing and an array of bags and shoes. Sometimes, however, it can be a potpourri of mismatched sizes and colors, not always the right stylistic choices or range of sizes. She added, to help with this, I asked Marks and Spencer, John Lewis and Partners, Jigsaw, and my friends, the designer Misha Nanu, if they were willing to design a capsule collection of more classic options for a workwear wardrobe. Taking the idea further, many of the brands agreed to use the one-for-one model. For each item purchased by a customer, one is donated to the charity. Not only does this allow us to be part of each other's story, it reminds us we are in it together.